So let's get started. Now, how we're going to do this is just for all our panelists to know. This is a session that we take up where we want all our IEEE foundation level participants just to know a little bit more about how your experience with the Mindler certification has been, and more than the certification, you know, that you've got from Mindler, how is career coaching something that has benefited you a lot, since all of you come from different streams, all of you had different experiences. So this is just a conversation, a candid conversation, where I'll ask you a couple of questions and we would want you to give honest answers to our participants. So I'll start off with Urvi. So Urvi, of course, I am not going to introduce Urvi. I will ask Urvi and each panelist to introduce themselves. And the reason for that is very simple, that I want you to know what their journey has been. And there is nobody better than them to share their journey. So Urvi, do ensure, and all panelists, do ensure that you mention which city you are from. That would really help everyone. They'll be able to connect with you. So Urvi, just a brief intro on just a little bit about yourself.
Good evening, everyone. Good evening to all my co-coaches, the mentors around, and the panelists. Good evening, participants. Myself, Professor Urvi Shukla, and I belong to Kolkata. I'm a lecturer at Calcutta University in Kolkata. And apart from that, I'm a career coach, certified career coach, the same program for which you are here. This program, IEEC, for which I'm sure all of you are very, very excited. You've been having a 2-day long session on it. I'll just give you a little brief on that. I started the program on IEEC that was in February 2018. And I was the first batch to do a foundation and an advanced program in the year February 2018. It's an absolutely fantastic program. It is a kind of a course for people. You can be from any walk of life, any. Myself, I don't belong to the field of psychology at all. Okay. But I am into the field of education last 18, 20 years now. If you have a passion towards helping students find out their best fit career, and what my aim is to get in clarity over confusion with the students have, this is the best kind of a career option for you. The IEEC program tries to help the career landscape of the entire country. So this is not only helping the students find their career, this will also help you get in an option to find a new career for yourself. I think that is the reason why you all are here. Everyone who's here is somewhat driven towards helping people in the society, especially the young minds which are there, which are totally confused, finding their best fit careers. So that is the reason why we all are here, trying to help them out. And I would assure you that this entire course is so intricately crafted that it consolidates all the things which are required to become a good career coach, good in question, in quotation marks. And I really like this word coach rather than being a counselor. So this certifies you to be a career coach. Apart from that, you will be meeting the mentors, the experts all across the globe. I have done my foundation, advanced, and master's, but we'll talk about the master's level later on. But right now, it provides you with a 3-level certification program from NCDA, CDA, and Mindler. And I know, I am sure all of you know that these are the apex body in the field of career counseling all across the globe. So all the best to all the participants. And I hope that we all can be a part of this big fraternity of career coaching.
Thank you so much, Urvi. Now I'll move on to Preeti. So Preeti, the question would be, you know, I know, so Preeti has been an educator for a very long time. She's been teaching. But I just want to understand from you right now, more than, more than what the advanced course entails, I would want to understand, why did you think of getting into career coaching? You know, just a little bit of background on just that for now.
Yeah. Hi, everyone. I'm Preeti Mehrotra from Bhopal. And as Isha asked me that what has driven me for taking this career counselor coach session or the course. So basically, I'm in the school from last 11 years. And Now my daughter is in grade 10. When she was in grade 9 and she started questioning me or friends, ma'am, you are so long from this teaching background. Can you suggest us which subjects we should take? Or so I feel like that and there's a big gap between my thinking level and now what the right now the situation is going on or right now the career options which children wants to pick up. So at that moment, and being a teacher, you are automatically a counselor too. So I thought, ki, why not to enhance my knowledge? And that was a COVID period. So I thought of enhancing my knowledge and plus searching for something which can really give me some new aspect of education or in this line. So I was scrolling further and I came across, I encountered with Mindler group, and definitely it's not that it's just a jumping a gun, but I have researched a lot about Mindler, and from everywhere, means whatever my research or my friends research for me, it was on the top, I must say. And they said, ki, you don't have to think, you don't have to give a second thought to it. Please close your eyes and join this if you want to go for it. And without second thought, I enrolled myself for this course. And I must say, participants, like when I did my foundation course, still there was a dilemma whether should I continue with the advanced or with masters or not. But the way these people have conducted the foundation course, okay, so that has given me a clear clarity that I'm going to be a career coach without any hindrance. And though I'm not have any, as Urvi said, I'm not having any psychological background. Even I am not having, I'm a throughout art student. And but this foundation course gave me the clear clarity. And I enrolled not only for advanced, but for the master's also. And right now I'm pursuing my master's. Advanced will give you the clarity that how you can take another career option. And I must say that from the same advanced group, four of us are there who have just started our startup. And Isha must be knowing that I have enrolled with the Mindler. We have taken the, we are partnered with the Mindler now. And soon we are going to rock on March with a Facebook online. So it's just doing the advanced means my many of the four friends have not done the advanced. Only I am the one who is continuing with the master's. But yes, why I will suggest master's too? Because master's will give you the clarity between the coach counseling and coaching.
Preeti, I'll just get back to that question. I have a list of questions, so apologies to cut you, but I want to get to that. I want everyone to know everybody's background, because for our participants, it's very important to know what a different mix, like Urvi, if you see, comes from a different background and how she ventured into career coaching. And I have so much to say about her, but I don't want to spill all the beans. Similarly, you come from the education where you've been teaching for so long and then you ventured into career coaching and now you're starting your own startup. Now I'll move on to Dinesh. So Dinesh and I have also known each other for a very long period of time. And I'll let Dinesh take this opportunity just to share a little bit about his journey and why he went into career coaching. So Dinesh, over to you.
Thank you, Isha. Hello, everyone. I'm Dinesh Lahoti. I'm from Guwahati, Assam. In career counseling, I used to work for math and science education. I'm a math and science communicator. I conduct math shows. I conduct math festival. While doing that, I realized that the way we decided the career choices and the way the students are deciding now, there is hardly there has not been any substantial changes. So something need to be done in terms of how the students decide on a career. But it's not all about only deciding on which particular career they want to go, but they also need a mentor, a guide, a coach who can help them develop the skills as well as the mindset required to excel in the chosen career. And I was searching for different programs and I came across Mindler's program. Initially, as Urvi said, that she was in the first batch, I was in the second batch. And initially we used to fly. Like I have to really, you guys are very lucky in a way because the whole foundation program is now available online. But I remember like when I had to attend it, I had to really go fly from Guwahati to Delhi to attend this 3 days program. But I think it was all worth it because the kind of learning that we had was really amazing. And I have been a partner with Mindler I think I'm very happy in terms of the kind of contribution that I'm able to make in students' community. So I'm very happy with that. And I can see the kind of value that the certification gives you, not only in terms of the credibility, because parents in schools, they also expect that you have some sort of credibility in the field of career counseling and mentoring. But more of that, you actually, you know, improve the craft of counseling and mentoring, I think, which is a very important value addition. Apart from the soft values like you being a certified coach, it gives, it definitely adds on your credibility. But yeah, I mean, the learning is really, I think, according to me, is much more important than, you know, the soft power as well.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Dinesh. I'll be back at you shortly. We have Ms. Gargi also with us. So Gargi, why don't you share a little bit about your journey? So Gargi is one of those people who has been in the space for a while. So Gargi, why don't you tell us a little bit about how your coaching journey has shaped up?
Good evening, everybody, the panelists, all the coaches, the mentors, and all the participants. Actually, I too also have started my career in education, moved on to training as a trainer, and then moved on to, of course, parallelly moved on to coaching. It's a long journey, more than 20 years now. But in 2018, I was in the second batch, as Abhishek was. So, you know, kind of when I was going through mindless, in fact, I was looking for something which would tell me or which will help me to test myself that am I on the right track? Am I doing the right justice to all the people who are coming and talking to me? Are we on the right track? Are we sharing the right information to people, which is very, very important? And there was a time hardly there are a few careers. And now I think if I tell 5,000 career will be there, the next day it could be 6,000. So it's something like that is happening. So this is one platform which has given me a testing that yes, I'm on the right track, or these are the things I need to do for myself to improve my own working patterns. And also it has connected me to a huge community of career coaches. It has also made me understand the finer differences, the finer action plans that I need to plan for and I need to work on. And I think I have improved a lot through the process. And actually, what I'm doing now or what I'm feeling now or I'm sharing with people now, I think I'm much more confident and much more informative and much more focused in what all are doing. So that's how this Mindler course, the advanced course, that time it was all together. Like it was one single course where we would do two things together, the first level as well as the second level. I too come from the same city as Urvi is. I'm also from Calcutta. So we all had to flew to Delhi to do the course, but it worked. And really, really, it has developed that kind of knowledge and information within myself and the inquisitiveness. So I have moved ahead with the next level also. It's a wonderful journey. And of course, a wonderful team of mine.
Great. Thank you so much, Gargi. Now I see Commander Yogesh also. I believe his internet and all the technical issues have been resolved. Can we just hear? Can you hear us? Just unmute yourself. You're on mute right now.
Yes, I think I'm good to go.
Perfect. Firstly, how are you feeling? Very important question.
It's manageable.
Okay. Thank you so much for your dedication to join us. We really appreciate it. So, why don't you just tell us a little bit about, you know, how you ventured into career coaching? Why was the transition that, you know, you made from your career to career coaching? If you could just give us a little brief on that.
Good afternoon, everybody. I am a bit different from all the renowned panelists here. I'll tell you something. I'm already into a major profession. I have my own consultancy. But it was this COVID when I was sitting at home and I had all the time when I saw this, as you all participants are, when you saw this, I said there are 2 weekends and this seems something interesting. Being a parent with 2 children who are adults now, have voter IDs of their own, there were a set of challenges bringing them up, you know, matching them up with their what they wanted. I felt sometimes that I lacked certain things as a parent. The atmosphere around lacked something. I had exposed my son to multiple of assessment tests and they were just not, you know, it was not working out. Honestly, I mean, he said, no, dad, this test doesn't tell me what I actually belong to. And So it's just not, so this, I just took 2 days, Saturday, Sunday. I said, there's no harm, go through it. I felt quite good. And then I decided to go ahead. I said, let's do it. So, I have some amount of, you know, that social part in me. I do some, a lot of social service. I said, why not this? You know, sit with the kids and learn. And when I went through the advanced course, the advanced course was an eye-opener. I've been totally from a non-psychology, being a 4G, you know, you understand what a 4G is all about. Rules, discipline, do this, don't do that. Pretty cut in stone. No? So that kind of, here I learned so many things. And I could reflect back on bringing up my children, their set of problems, the problems of their friends, other children around. And I said, yeah, this is what it is. And then when I read about the masters and I learned about it, the advanced told me, okay, good, I've learned, I can start coaching now. But then there is more to it. And as I go through the grind of advanced, the master's course now, we are in the midst of it. Priti is my batchmate here. I'm really enjoying it. I mean, though it's a grind, but the facets which you are learning, the things which you are getting exposed to, you know, the understanding of behaviors, you know, how to help someone, why we go through all this, what are the problems? I just heard a bit of what Dinesh said. I think, yes, the advanced course did give you the tools to start with, to do a job, a reasonably good job. I think the master's is taking it to a different level. I really don't know whether I will go ahead and do a full-time career coaching as a profession, because my present profession is taking enough of time of me. But I think whatever one or two or, you know, a dozen students I am able to help out, I think I am going to do a better job. That's what I feel.
Thank you. Perfect. Thank you so much. Now we also have Abhishek with us. Now Abhishek is actually working with Mindlaw, and I introduced you to him this afternoon also. And of course, he's going to be taking a couple of sessions in the advanced level. But I also thought I'll call Abhishek because Abhishek has also undergone the advanced and master's level. I just wanted to understand from Abhishek in general also, Abhishek, why did you get into career coaching? I mean, he's from a high-flying management background, went to UCL. I am getting down into the details of what he has done, which I don't want to, but let's understand from you, Abhishek, why did you get into career coaching? Of course, you are very passionate about overseas consulting and education, but if you could just help us a little bit on that.
Of course, Isha, thank you so much. And in fact, I'm glad you asked me that question. So I'll answer in a twofold way, because all my panelists have done a great job and I know all of them very well. So they've done a wonderful job explaining about the course. My reason, first one would be my lack of awareness growing up. I come from a boarding school. That means, I think that's my fault. I wasn't aware about a lot of careers when I was growing up. And I mean, 7-8 years ago when I was in class 11, 12, trust me, I think I was of the opinion, okay, these are the number of careers, because we were only talking to our friends and listening to whatever they're doing. So that was a lack of awareness. And I honestly felt that when I actually got out looking for colleges, be it studying abroad or wherever, even in India, we had the opportunities, but nobody was talking about that. So that actually made me wonder throughout that, you know, why is it happening? But of course, at that point of time, I don't think I had it in me to help someone out, because to be able to help someone, you need to help yourself first to understand how the journey is. The second point is, I think throughout my journey, so I have worked in two very diverse industries, you know, as well, luxury and education. So someone looking at it might feel that they're very different industries, but ironically, I mean, it's actually the same, because the skill set you bring across, coming especially from a management background, is the same. I only talk to people the entire day. That's all you're supposed to do. So that is something which allowed me to help people and talk to them. But most importantly, Isha, I think when I was going through the program as well, what I realized was that sometimes as a coach, we are only trying to provide options to them, which they might already know about, but not be able to reflect on them. We are just, I think, aiding them or helping them get into the best possible option. And they haven't been able to explore those. I would like to give the credit to the wonderful people I've worked in my journey with, be it at Mindlaw or before as well. And when I mean these people, they have been my managers, the people who hired me throughout any of the organizations. I always say with a lot of gratitude, I've worked with some of the major organizations, but those people have always mentored me to do better. And I think that's what a coach is supposed to do, which I think as a concept is really flawed, that people don't understand the importance. I'll just leave it to one small thing. I mean, it was very convenient for me to tell someone to buy a diamond and sell it, which was not a necessity. It's equally difficult for me to tell a parent to that how important coaching is for the kid, which is very ironical. So I think all of us would agree here as coaches, that's something we are bound to do. That was my primary reason, Isha.
That was a very powerful line. I have to admit to that. So thank you so much, Abhishek. I'll be right back with you. Now let's take it from Dinesh. So Dinesh, why don't you help us understand how the ICCC advanced level and the master's level are completely different? And do you think it is necessary to do both advanced and master's together? Like, what are your two thoughts on that?
Yeah, so in advance, what we learned was actually understood the whole career landscape in a more better way, and a more with a more different in a holistic perspective. Right? What according to me, master's level did was that I think at that time we became better coaches, because it really helps you to understand how to coach and how to mentor a student in a more structured way, and why there are different facets of mentoring and coaching. And I think after doing a master's program, I can personally feel that apart from the whole experience of learning from people like, you know, the leaders in the field of career mentoring and career coaching, like David and Barbara, you know, Chadda sir, apart from that learning experience, I think it has really, you know, kind of improved the skill sets that we need to become a better coach. So according, it helped me drastically. So I think according to me, like broadly speaking, advanced level made me a better career guide and career counselor, and master's level actually helped me hone my coaching skills more.
Thank you, Dinesh. So that was great. Urvi, why don't you help us understand how the advanced and the master's level were completely different? And, you know, I know that you were the first person even to do the master's level, like you were in the first batch. And you know, had like maybe you did your master's after 1 year of having done your advanced. So if you could just help us understand how you applied your advanced learning in that 1 year, and how the master's program further equipped you with the right skill sets.
As I said, I was the first batch with the advanced program in 2018, and the master's program was launched sometime in November 2019. So it was almost after completion of my certification of almost a year that I did my master's program. For both, as I said, I was there in the first batch. Advanced was opening all the loose ends and exposing all people from all the various walks of life into the field of career coaching, of which no one had absolute no idea of if you were not from a psychological background. As Gargi ma'am said, we traveled from Kolkata to Delhi to do this advanced program, which was a 3-day program where people were there from various fields and from various parts of the country. So the entire concept of this career landscape being opening up and career coaching as an opportunity for people from all walks of life as a new age career came up. Till now, people did not know, or rather they were not aware about the fact of on importance of being a career coach. This was such a prestigious career for your own self about which awareness was lacking. So as we say, it is difficult to make the students aware or their parents how important it is to plan out their career. At our age, when we are at a threshold of one career or wanting to move on, this came as a great opportunity for all of us as to look in for something else, where we all who were there in this field or who are there, we all have one common drive that we all want to help. Help is a very big word. Okay, so helping skills was something which we all had, but somewhere hidden, we could not just take it out. So the master's program polished us. It gave us an edge, a threshold over all our knowledge that we had. People, as I said, they were principals, teachers, educators. Everyone had a lot of baggage, educational degree baggage, which everyone was carrying. But I think at this level, everyone should keep their baggages below. This was the time to learn unlearn and relearn the entire concept of career coaching and counseling without keeping an ego in between us, or without thinking that I've already been educated with so many degrees of a graduation, post-graduation, master's, PhD, everything. We should keep all that aside. This is absolutely a new plethora of career options for us, and we should do full justice. And master's program is very extensive, very detailed, but it will definitely give you a cutting edge. It will carve your own niche into your field, and it will help you improve as an individual. So our own skills are developed, our own skills are sharpened. It gives us new technique, and we learn from the experts. And the most prestigious thing was the CCSP certificate. We are given an opportunity to be a service provider. So I think that's really icing on the cake, that we are eligible to help and guide and mentor people who need us. So I think that's the major difference between the two.
Great. So Urvi is somebody, you know, I mean, I'm just sharing a couple of lines on her. She, of course, comes with so much experience. She's already a professor, and you should have seen the dedication with which she did the advanced and master's level. She was almost like an 8-year-old or a 10-year-old kid. Till the time she didn't get clarity on all the questions she had, she would go on asking those questions. And I think that is so important. She kept asking questions. She didn't keep her, you know, she was just so candid in the whole learning experience that we thoroughly enjoyed. Like, till the time she didn't understand everything properly, she kept asking, she kept reaching out to the mentors. And I felt that, you know, that was again something that would have helped you, you know, connecting and reaching your mentors as and when you wanted. So thank you so much, Urvi.
Thank you.
Let's now move on to Abhishek. Abhishek, why don't you help us understand? So Abhishek is someone who's in the system, you know, he is a part of Team Mindler. He in fact is also a cohort manager of ICCC advanced cohorts and master's cohorts. So Abhishek, how was the advanced and master's level different for you? How did it give you, like, what did you learn from both of them?
Absolutely, Isha. So I'll quickly help everyone understand that what I learned in the theoretical part of it. So before doing the advanced courses as well, I had already started, you know, consulting with students in particular, like Isha said, about overseas education. But I always wondered this, because if I was speaking to a parent in particular, they always have this in mind and they would question me as well. And I think rightly so, that, you know, why are you doing this and how are you doing this if you're not certified? And that made me always wonder. First of all, credibility, I want to just get it out of the way, is the most important thing for a coach. We don't even go to a restaurant without looking at the ratings. I mean, how are we supposed to go to a coach if the coach is not credible? So that's the first thing. And I think all of us agree here, and we've been through the journey. It's a major difference. That's one. In terms of the course, whenever I used to speak to a student in particular, I saw a major difference in my approach, especially because I don't come from a psychology background at all. And I did not know about the theories before I actually went through the advanced curriculum. Of course, that is the major difference in master's level as well. You take a step ahead when you get to interact with David and Barbara and Dr. Chadha, of course, and they help you understand those things better. I'm not saying it's something very easy, but of course, if you pay attention enough and give it enough time, you get a hold of it. Advanced and master's just makes it very, I think, for the lack of a better word, convenient for you to understand the complexities. And it does not matter, you don't come from psychology. I think that way I'm lucky. I work with so many people at Mindler who come from, you know, even Isha, Vaishnavi, Shilpa ma'am, everyone comes from major backgrounds in psychology, but there are enough of us there as well. Prateek as well doesn't come from psychology, and some of us are here. I see Dr. Yogesh is laughing. So that is a major advantage as well. Other factor, which is very important, is the kind of concepts, Isha, in master's level, like job employment and, you know, market study, especially in a scenario like what happened last year. If as a coach, we are not aware about the market conditions, I don't think we should be doing this, because we won't be aware about how do we help others, which also requires that. This is something, Isha, I want to just take a step ahead and mention that as a coach, when we are pursuing masters in advance as well, we have to keep updating ourselves. And the biggest advantage or hack which we have with this ICCC program is we get to learn a lot from people from different industries. We don't even have to look beyond. I think the major advantage even I had was with the people I was working with. In fact, Ms. Gargi said, she was there in my cohort. She has a different background. Everyone has a very, very different background. So I think it's a very selfish thing to say, but you learn a lot from the people you are, you know, studying with as well. So that's again a major takeaway. And of course, it goes without saying, all the mentors who are helping you out through advanced and masters are brilliant. So you get to take a lot from them. And one last thing, of course, when you are It just gives you more confidence. I always used to ask Parikshit, sir, how do I actually help out a student who's older than me? Because it gets in a situation that they'll feel, how do I do that? He's like, if you are credible, nobody will question that ever. And I've seen that difference after getting a CCSP, that nobody's ever asked me that question in particular. And I'm actually working with a few PhD clients in the last 6 or 8 months. So that has been only possible because of the credentialing. So that's my takeaway, Isha.
Thank you so much, Abhishek. Now I'll move on to Gargi. Gargi, why don't you help us understand, you know, we would like to hear your perspective of, you know, how the advanced and master's level were different.
I think everybody has already said a lot about this. So it's more very similar to that. But to me, there are two things which are very, very important. Firstly, I think this question of whether you have psychology as your background or not, it really does not matter in the whole process. The learning pattern or the learning curve has been designed in such a way. The most important requirement is whether you have the passion, whether you have a logical mind, or are you ready to, I think, unlearn and relearn. That's the most important part of it, the journey. And are you ready to learn at every moment? Because it's a dynamic field. It's changing every day, I think every hour there's something happening in this field. So if we are ready and passionate about that, that's the great thing about it. When I started the advanced, it's just opened the window. It has opened the window. It has brought to me some ideas. It has showed me that, you know, how scientifically it can be organized. But when I moved on to the master's, I think that is where you need to be very, very research oriented. Like the self-interest to learn, self-research and reflection is the key word to be successful in the master's program. And of course, you know, you get to meet a lot of people who are sharing knowledge with you. You get to meet your mentors who are from very eminent in the field and from across the globe. And of course, you know, the way... this master's course, I have taken this master's course, is I just have started from scratch. I thought that I know nothing about it, and I did every research right from the base and started developing myself to see that, yes, later on I can correlate my past knowledge with this. And it's a wonderful learning process where I think passion is the key word. And the interest to help people is the key word. So masters will make you a true coach. You know, one thing I would like to share before I, you know, just stop saying this, is that counselor is something I used to be. But after doing the master's course, I think I have shaped up as a good, as people say, as a career coach. And I think I do justice to coaching. Not counseling now. That's a huge difference. There's a huge gap. And many of us, we do not understand. And I think we just jump into a lot of things, which is not right.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Gargi. Now I'll move on to Commander Yogesh, and he is actually in the middle of his master's level. But I would still want to understand from him how the advanced and master's level have been different, you know, just some thoughts on that.
What the other panelists have already said it, but I'd like to go the way I look at it, what I have been learning. It's actually more than helping. I mean, sometimes that term help can be taken as that when somebody is weak enough and is not able to do something. But I feel that skills which have been taught to us, the theories which have been taught to us, are actually more about facilitating. Okay, being useful to someone, bringing out his innate strengths. So what we have learned from advanced, where all the skill sets, the career domain, you know, Dinesh said, the expanse of it, the elements of it, and those things. But here I think we are learning more about ourselves, to reach out to people to actually facilitate their growth. You know, make them aware of their present state, or take them from their present state to a future state using their strengths. You know, I didn't know all these terms before this, but the concept of positive psychology, where you know, you don't look back into a person's weaknesses and hanker upon that this is what went wrong with you. It's about seeing what's right with you, okay, assisting him in, you know, accepting his probably weaknesses or, you know, bringing them a bit more up, but rather building up more on the individual strengths. And I can correlate exactly that with, you know, my experience with armed forces was that we never hankered upon a person's weakness. Our trainings were uniform, but then everybody couldn't come to the same, but then we used each one to his strengths. Okay, so I see that as a great point of this master. Second thing is, it broadens your horizon. Again, relating back to my profession of a military man, okay, we were taught to focus on target and this thing, but the awareness of the surroundings, the broadening of the horizon to know who's where and that, this master's course is teaching me to look at a problem on a larger perspective. Not just about a career as such, because career is not independent of life. So the other aspects which come, you know, my family gets connected with me, you know, after some time the career is not permanent. But then it's my life is, the people who are connected with me are, then how do I bring in these changes together? So I think those are very beautiful aspects of this master's program.
Great. Thank you so much. I feel that gave a lot of perspective, and I'm sure our participants also got the difference between advanced and masters. Preeti, anything? I know that I have made everyone speak before you, so everyone's already given all possible, their thoughts on how they are different. But if there's anything you'd like to add, Preeti, on how the advanced and masters has been different for you and how both have been equally important. Would you just want to...
Actually, already everybody has covered the entire difference between the counseling and coaching. And one thing which I want to say, I just want to say what Kargi ma'am said, that we need to be ready with the unlearn and to relearn. That is very important. As being a teacher from 11 years, I have really, it has widened my scope of understanding the problem after doing the master's. Now I'm able to understand taking the problems in a different manner. I also see the other side of the problem. So this you learn, and definitely your helping skills being only enhanced and being defined more and skilled when you are doing the master's. So even I myself is now very much clear the vast difference between the counseling and coaching, and what Yogesh said. Yogesh and me are the same batch, so yes, what he said, yes, I can relate it with that. Thank you.
Perfect. Thank you so much, Preeti. I wanted to ask all of you if it's okay if we share your email IDs with our participants, because there are tons of questions, and I'll request Raghav, Shagun or Ashwarya to put everybody's email IDs and LinkedIn IDs so they can all connect. But let's move on from ICCC now. Let's move on to partner platforms. So, like, of course, ICCC is a certification program, and what next? What does everyone do after ICCC? Of course, there are associate and ambassador opportunities, which all of you know of. But we have a lot of the ICCC members who go ahead and take our SaaS platform, which is the partner portal. Dinesh, if you would just share a couple of lines, maybe not very long since we have only 6-7 minutes left. If you could just tell us as to how your experience has been using the partner portal.
Yeah, so many congratulations for creating that. I always say this. To whenever I get a chance. I think your SaaS platform is really amazing. It enables us to really not only conduct the assessments online, but at the same time, we can actually help them create a pathway for them. And for students, I think it's really very powerful, especially in the times of pandemic when we wanted to do the assessments and all, but there was always a limitation whether they have to come to our center or come to a specific place and do the assessment. I think it really helped, and the partner platform really helped you not only in terms of the kind of tools and things that are available, but also the support that we get from Mindler team is also phenomenal.
Great. Thank you so much. Urvi, why don't you help us understand a little bit more about the partner portal? What I will do is I will also share all your website links with our participants so they can have a look at the same. So Urvi, over to you about how the partner platform has been.
I have been using the partner platform almost 7 to 8 months. They helped me launch my website, which I launched in the month of October during the time of the COVID period. The partner platform is extremely, extremely informative. It is hands-on information, just a button click away. It has all the things which is required for you as a coach to keep a track of. It has a very personalized, updated dashboard. It gives you a client, that is student and a client records on the career assessments. It tells you about the roadmap to be taken, the action plan about on that particular child, what we have planned. We can just make notes on that and keep it ready. So it helps us, you know, to recapitulate or rewind when this client comes to us on the second time. Apart from that, the career library is extremely informative. The career blogs are very informative. I'm extremely happy with the partner platform. It is very informative, updated. And if there is any technical glitch in which I am unable to generate a report or any such thing, the Mindler team is extremely efficient, few seconds away, and they are ready to help you. So I'm very happy with the partner platform.
Thank you. Raghav, if you could just share everybody's website also on the chat so everyone can have a look at all our partners' websites. Commander Yogesh, over to you. I know you also recently started using the partner portal, but how has your experience been so far?
Dinesh and Urvi have already told that was a platform, partner platform. Yes, I find a non-intrusive, invasive way of communication with my coaches through this platform very important. You know, I don't have to call them up or keep sending SMSs. It's there in their profile to see what assignments I've given them. I can give them links to study. I can give them assignments which they can connect back with me. So I really don't have to, you know, keep sending messages or keep calling to do some follow-ups. That's the thing. Apart from this, like career libraries and blogs which are there for them to read. Another thing I found good about the career platform was after the assessment also, which they go through the psychological assessment, there's a small little assessment of how they manage themselves. Okay, now that becomes, as you analyze the assessment reports, that also comes as a very strong pointer to the way they connect up with themselves and their career profile and their life. Plus then, I think once I've shared, I could, by the timelines which you have given, I mean, once in one particular case, I could see that one of my students had accelerated through certain parts of it at a very high rate and scored quite well. And later I came to know that she was being helped by her father at that point of time. You know, I could get onto that straight, and then I could ask them, why did you do that? So it seems the father was quite keen on pushing the child onto a particular, in a particular direction. So that platform, I mean, without that platforms and the time zones which are given, I couldn't have analyzed that.
Yeah.
So I think it's pretty good. And I after finishing my master's program, I'll actually be exploring it much more than what I do now.
Perfect, great. So now I'll move on to Gargi, and we're also heading very close in time. So Gargi, if you can actually help us. So just for all of you to know, Gargi actually works very close with Nirmal. You all attended Nirmal's session yesterday, so they work very closely, and Gargi is the one who coaches all the clients that Nirmal gets, and then of course Nirmal also comes in for the overseas part. So how has the platform been for you, since you've already been coaching for a long time? So how did the platform help you and benefit you, you know, to another level?
Firstly, I think the library is an excellent thing that is what we can use. Of course, along with the library, the blogs are equally important. And I think
Gargi, you're on mute.
That we the platform that we initially had, like there was a change. There's a formatting change. There's a change of color coding and everything. I think, you know. Understanding the platform is much easier now, and working on the platform, keeping all the information on the platform. The activity section where we can actually overview some add-on things which were not initially there. That Actually, I'm in a very remote area.
Oh.
At times, there's a connectivity issue.
No problem.
So that, that is one. I think it's very useful. It gives me not only to it does it not only the way it has been presented, the assessment reports and the detailing of the assessment, the way it is being presented, it's very easy to analyze. Also, it is very informative in terms of that just a button to click, you get all the information which you can share with your clients and things like that. So it's very, very useful, knowledgeable,